Our text for the exhortation tonight is taken from Isaiah chapter 43. And we are reading verses 18 and 19. And the topic we're looking at is, God will do a new thing. Can you say that with me? God will do a new thing. Now personalize it. God will do a new thing in my life. One more time. God will do a new thing in my life. Shall they believe in amen? Isaiah chapter 43. And we're reading verses 18 and 19. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Now verse 19, let's read together. Everybody, one, two, go. Behold, now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I, God, will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. That shall be your experience at the end of this service today. It says, now it shall spring forth. Everybody say with me, now. Say it again, now. The loudest you can, now. Please be reminded of the fact that we serve a now God. Not a God of tomorrow or a God of yesterday. We serve a now God. And our now God does new things every moment. In actual fact, Lamentations chapter 3 tells us in verse 23, it says they are new every morning. New every morning. God will do a new thing in your life now. Even in this service, he will do something new in your life. It will affect the entirety of your life. It will reflect in your family life. The new thing that God will do in your life will affect your finances. It will affect your career. It will affect your health, your physical body. If you believe that, let your amen show it. So we serve a now God who specializes in doing new things in the now. So thank God for all that God has done in your life in time past, before now, up until the year 2012. But here we are in the year 2013. What God is going to begin to do in your life this year will make what you have ever experienced in the past look like nothing. Can I hear a believing amen? Now, it shall spring forth. But remember, every change of level requires an encounter with God. You are not just going to be changing level, you'll be changing levels. So your encounter and my encounter with God has to be on a continuous basis. And what a joy as you partake of his flesh and blood again tonight, he will yet give you a higher encounter. And as that happens, he will change your level. In this service tonight, somebody is changing level. If you are that person, say, that's me. Say it again, that's me. New things in your life. But for you and I to partake of the new things that God is ready to do, it's important for us to know the position we must take. It's been declared prophetically this year. Double portion, next levels. The prophecy has gone ahead. There is no doubt that it's going to be fulfilled. But it must be fulfilled in your own life. You and I are meant to be partakers. We are not meant to be onlookers. Rather, we are meant to be partakers. You have listened to other people's testimonies over the years in time past. But this year, double portion, next levels, people have to listen to you. Say with me, people must have to listen to me. So for you and I to partake of the new things that God is ready to do in the now, we must know, understand what is expected of us. For you and I to partake and remain partakers of these new things that God will do, number one, very important, we must believe it. Luke 1:45. Blessed is she that believeth, for there shall be a performance. So the performance is not for everybody that hears it, or that writes it down, or that has the prophetic declaration on the leaflet. The performance is only for those who believe. You have the pamphlet in your hand. Welcome on board 2013. How much of it do you believe? One of the prophetic declarations there says that God will be turning every area of concern in your life to testimony. Do you believe that? Say with me, I believe it. It says God will be turning your morning into dancing. That means no more midnight wetting of your pillows with tears. It says, weep not. We were told over and again, and especially last night, God's servant emphasized it again in several places. All of these things that the Bible declares. And among it says, no more oppression for you. Wherever you have been oppressed in time past, an end comes to it today. Yeah. Say with me, no more oppression. It says, blessed is she that believeth. So for you and I to be partakers of the new things that God is ready to do, we must believe it. We must believe it. Double portion, next levels is real. For you and I to be partakers, we must believe it. From the depth of our hearts, John chapter 11 and verse 40, Jesus himself speaking says, Jesus saith unto her, said I not unto thee that if thou wouldest believe, thou should see the glory of God? If you believe, you will see these prophecies fulfilled in your life. If you believe, then truly your levels will keep changing from one level of glory to another. If you believe, then truly you will enjoy double portion. That will be your experience. Remember the story of Jacob in Genesis chapter 32 and verse 28. Before Jacob met Esau, he had an encounter with God, and he was told, as a prince, you have prevailed. Jacob believed it, and he went ahead to meet with Esau with confidence, and his story changed for the better. Someone's story is changing tonight. Say, that's me. So believe it. Number two, very important, prepare for it. If you and I must be partakers, we must prepare for it. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 1. The preparation of the heart in man and the answer of the tongue is from the Lord. Prepare for it. God will only dispatch to you what you are prepared to receive. God will only dispatch to you what you are prepared to receive. Prepare for it. Prepare for it. You can imagine in a home where a new baby is being expected to be born. There is preparation, cleaning everywhere. Even arrangement in the bedroom, in the sitting room, everywhere is changing. New items are coming into the home from the market. Old items in the home are giving way. Where is the baby cot going to be? There is preparation. You see a pregnant woman that is full time and is expectant. You don't have any doubt, do you? She doesn't have to announce to you that, oh, I'm close to my delivery. The tummy speaks for itself. Amen? So there is preparation both on the end of the mother. There is preparation in the home by everybody. Everyone is preparing for a new baby. If there is preparation for a new baby in the natural, how much more should there be preparation in the world of the spirit? Amos chapter 4 and verse 12 therefore says clearly, O Israel, prepare to meet your God. Prepare. If you and I must experience the double portion new levels that God has declared for us this year 2013, then we must prepare. We must prepare. And one major area of preparation is cleansing, making ourselves ready and fit, because every new blessing from God requires a new you and a new me. Every new blessing from God requires a new you and a new me. Cleansing, purification. And then the word of God in 2 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 1 makes it very, very clear. Let us cleanse ourselves, therefore, from every form of filthiness of the flesh and of the spirit. Filthiness of the spirit. Spiritual laxity. Spiritual laziness. Spiritual insensitivity. Filthiness of the flesh and of the spirit. Envy. Strife. Covetousness. Lying. Cheating. Let us cleanse ourselves. Husband and wife, you live under the same roof, but there is strife. The new thing that God is talking about cannot land in your home. It cannot. At work, if you get involved in cheating, the new thing that God is talking about, this double portion, this next level, may elude you until you clean up. Filthiness. Immorality of any kind. If you give room to such, you are actually deliberately removing yourself from this agenda of double portion and next levels. That will not be you. And so tonight, if you partake of the Lord's table, we eat his flesh and drink his blood, cleansing from every form of filthiness of the spirit and of the flesh will be our portion in Jesus' name. Can I hear a believing amen? Amen. When we cleanse ourselves and then we make ourselves ready for the new thing that God has in stock for us, your portion another will not take. Can I hear a believing amen? Amen. And finally, number three, declare it. Number one, believe it. Number two, prepare for it. And finally, number three, declare it. Don't just declare it, but declare it boldly. How? How should you declare it? How should you declare it? John chapter 11 and verse 43. Jesus got to the tomb of Lazarus. After all said and done, he had to make declaration. He cried, the Bible says, with a loud voice. What did he say? Lazarus, come forth. You believe God's prophetic agenda? Declare it. Next levels is my portion. I don't know about you. Double portion is. Turn to your neighbor, tell him or her, next levels is my portion. Double portion is my portion. Tell your neighbor the same thing for him. Next levels is your portion. And double portion is your portion. Say loud amen if you believe that. Bold declaration. You look at those prophetic declarations that you have in your pamphlet, and continue to declare boldly, God has turned for me my mourning into dancing. Every area of concern in my life this year, 2013, is turned to testimonies. Bold declaration. The Bible says, declare now that thou mayest be justified. Remember David and Goliath? David looked at Goliath. And the Bible tells us in 1 Samuel chapter 17 and verse 37. 1 Samuel 17, 37. David looked at Goliath. He said, the Lord that delivered me out of the paw of the lion and out of the paw of the bear, he will deliver me out of the hand of this Philistine. And Saul said unto David, go, and the Lord be with you. God has delivered you in time past from several things. He will do it again. But this time, he will do it much more speedily. Can I hear a loud amen? Amen. And then in verse 46, you see what happened there? 1 Samuel chapter 17 and verse 46. The Bible says, this day will the Lord deliver thee into my hand, and I will smite thee and take thine hand. And then if you go down the line, the Bible says, God made it happen. As you make bold declaration, God will establish it for you. Remember Joshua and Caleb? 12 spies went. 10 said, we are not able. But Numbers chapter 13, Caleb and Joshua stood in verse 30 and they said, we are well able. We are well able. I stand here today to declare to somebody, all that God has declared concerning you this year 2013, you are well able to lay hold on them. You are well able. I am well able. Say with me, I am well able. I am taking possession of that which belongs to me. Say it again. I am well able, and I am taking possession of that which belongs to me. Shall they believe in amen? As you have declared it, God will make it happen for you. God will do a new thing in your life, even today in this service. And so if you came in here tonight to this service with anything that is contrary to double portion, next levels in any area of your life, in your health, in your finances, in your career, in your family life, is dropping off here. You are not returning back home with anything that does not belong to you. Why? God has declared it. Every area of concern of your life shall be turned to testimony. Say with me, I receive it. I believe it. I prepare for it. And I declare it. Shall they believe in amen? In a moment, I'd like you to rise up on your feet right now. And you will make that declaration just 1 minute. Lord, you have declared a double portion next levels. I receive it. I believe it. I prepare for it. I declare it. Lift up your voice to the Lord right now. Just 1 moment, 1 minute. And make that declaration. I receive it. I believe it, Lord. I prepare for it. Double portion. Next level. In every area of my life. Lord, I take possession. I shall not be denied. It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. Double portion. Next level. Boldly. I declare it. I declare it. I declare it. Thank you, Father. I give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.